Now know from intercepted phone calls that the Chinese consulate sought to influence this prime minister by making a $140,000 donation to the Trudeau Foundation, a donation that was arranged and signed off on by the prime minister's own brother. This was for the specific purpose of influencing the prime minister's decisions as liberal leader and eventually prime minister. Does the prime minister really expect us to believe he has never discussed the Trudeau Foundation with his brother since that donation?
The Honorable Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, as I have said, I have had no engagement, direct or indirect, with the Trudeau Foundation in close to 10 years. And that includes not knowing about what donations are taking, what decisions they're making, or what my brother is doing on the foundation. I have made that decision 10 years ago to not engage with the foundation, and that is what we have all been consistent with.
The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
He has no direct or indirect involvement with the Trudeau Foundation? Really? Because the annual report for 21-22 lists him as an inactive member and says that he is only withdrawn from the affairs of the foundation for the duration of his involvement in federal politics, meaning he can go back to that big pile of cash when he leaves office, cash that was contributed to by the regime in Beijing. Why does the prime minister keep making statements of falsehood about his involvement with his family foundation?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, I believe the Leader of the Opposition needs to look in a dictionary for the definition of inactive. It goes exactly to what I have said. I have had no involvement, direct or indirect, with the Trudeau Foundation for 10 years. I am completely inactive in that sense because I am active delivering benefits for Canadians, delivering growth for the middle class, delivering dental benefits that member voted against, delivering a child benefit, delivering child care that have made a huge difference for Canadians. That's what I'm active doing, not any of that other stuff.
The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Well, I did look up the word inactive, and you know what it does not include? Getting the donors of the Trudeau Foundation to pay for your vacation. It does not include getting members of the Trudeau Foundation to be appointed as the election interference watchdog. It does not include appointing a rapporteur to look into that same interference who was an active member of the Trudeau Foundation. And it does not include having a brother who facilitated the donation from a foreign dictatorship. How does the Prime Minister reconcile his inactive involvement with all of those activities?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Watching at home may be surprised to see the extent to which the Leader of the Official Opposition is choosing to focus on me. When they are worried about affordability, they are worried about growth, they are worried about health care, when we are moving forward with a budget that delivers a grocery rebate to Canadians, that delivers health care, that delivers dental care, that delivers a plan for great jobs for the middle class for the coming years, and that member and his entire party will be voting against that budget that helps Canadians tonight. Shame on them, Mr. Speaker. We should be helping Canadians here. That's not what he's doing.
Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
What he's doing is helping himself to Trudeau Foundation donor money, helping himself by using the influence that his office gives to indirectly generate donations to the Trudeau Foundation. Mm-hmm. And speaking of that, his brother was the one that orchestrated the donation from the Beijing dictatorship to the Trudeau Foundation. He personally attended the announcement of the donation, and it's his name that signed the agreement for the donation. So once again, has the Prime Minister discussed the Trudeau Foundation with his brother since that donation was received?
Right Honourable Prime Minister.
I've already said no to that question. No is the answer. But at the same time, as he tries to focus on me and spinning all sorts of different conspiracy theories, we will continue to stay focused on Canadians, on delivering on our commitments in Budget 2023 with affordability, including the grocery rebate, including a cracking down on hidden junk fees and predatory lending, introducing auto filing for taxes for low-income Canadians. We're there to support Canadians during this difficult time. The Leader of the Opposition is going to be voting against that tonight, voting against the support for Canadians that we are going to continue to deliver despite his attacks.
The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
Speaker, there's no attack. We're simply asking him to do what every other Canadian would normally do. The average Canadian pays for their own camping trip, pays for their own family vacation. He gets his vacations funded by Trudeau Foundation donors. We're not asking for him to pay for the security or even for the private jet. We're simply asking for him to pay back the $80,000 gift that he got from his wealthy friends in Bermuda, donors to the Trudeau Foundation. Will he get this IOU out of his pocket and pay the money back?
Right, Honourable Prime Minister.
Speaker, while the Leader of the Opposition continues to focus on me, we will continue to focus on Canadians, including moving forward on strengthening health care. We are in the process of signing historic deals with all the provinces to deliver more family doctors, to deliver better mental health care, to deliver a better supports for our frontline workers and a reduction of backlogs, and to deliver better data collection right across the country so we can make sure Canadians are getting the best possible health care from coast to coast to coast. On top of that, we're moving forward with a dental care plan that's going to deliver dental care for Canadians right across the country, and he voted against it.
The Leader of the Opposition.
Mr. Speaker, the Prime Minister really expects us to believe that he has not discussed this donation that the dictatorship in Beijing directed to the Trudeau Foundation, even though it was his brother that signed off on the donation, orchestrated the transaction, and signed the agreement to bring the money home. He really expects us to believe that, then a very simple question. Will he agree to have his brother come before a parliamentary committee to testify about foreign interference in our country, yes or no?
The Right Honourable Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, I believe that you can perhaps rule on this. There is a convention in Parliament that assumes and that accepts that members are telling the truth. So I don't know how many times I have to say no to his question that he is asking. I don't know why it's so hard for people in the Conservative Party of Canada to accept that no means no, but we will continue to answer these questions in full truthfulness, and we will continue, despite his mudslinging and his personal attacks, to focus on delivering things for Canada. Now, the member opposite and everyone in this House has an opportunity to accelerate the grocery rebate. Will they accept the unanimous consent motion that does that?